Hi friends, welcome back to my channel The Joy of Cooking. I am Aishwarya Sunil Bivalkar and today I'll be showing you all the butter beans usal. It's very easy to make. It's a Maharashtrian recipe and very healthy recipe. So let's begin and learn how to make lima beans curry. Lima beans, that is the val or birde as we call it. We are going to soak it in water for about 8 to 10 hours and then drain the water and keep them for sprouting. So we want the sprouted val. So after about 8 to 10 hours we'll get the sprouts. So soak it in water for about 8 to 10 hours, then drain the water and then let them sprout for the next 8 to 10 hours. And after that, once they're sprouted, we are going to remove the skin of the val and they are ready to be used. So first we are going to make the chili and the onion paste. For that, in a pan I have added 2.5 teaspoon of oil, and make sure that the oil is nice and hot. Once the oil is hot, we are going to add garlic cloves to this. So I will be adding about 3 to 4 garlic cloves. The cloves over here are a little big, some are very small, so I'll be adding 5 cloves over here. And then I'm going to add dried red chilies. I'll be adding 3 chilies over here. And now we're going to give it a good stir and let the garlic become a little light golden brown in color. Once it's nice light golden brown, we'll add onions to this. So here I'll be adding sliced onions. I'm using 2 medium sized onions. I have sliced them. And now we're going to mix it and let the onions become nice translucent. You'll see the onions have become translucent. So at this stage we're going to add 2 teaspoons of coriander seeds. And 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds. This will add to the flavor of the dish. So coriander seeds and cumin seeds are very important in this recipe. And we are going to give it a good stir and let this cook and become a little light golden brown in color. Once this is done, we are going to add coconut to this. So first I'll be adding dried coconut. I have grated it. I'm using about 1/4 cup of dried coconut, grated dried coconut. And for some more coconutty flavor, I'm going to add some fresh coconut. 2 tablespoons of fresh coconut, scraped coconut. And now we're going to mix this and let this cook on medium to high flame, and then add some salt as per taste. And now we're going to mix this. Make sure that it becomes a little dark golden brown in color, but not too heavy dark. And once it's nice golden brown in color, we'll be switching off the flame. So first make sure that it's combined and the coconut has become nice light golden brown in color, and then we're going to add some coriander leaves. Now coriander leaves are actually optional, you may avoid this completely, but here I'll be adding about 2 tablespoons of coriander leaves with some stalks in it, and mix this really well. And once it becomes nice golden brown in color, we are going to switch off the flame. So combine it well. And then switch off the flame. Done. Now let this mixture cool down at room temperature. And once it's cooled at the room temperature, we are going to make a fine paste out of this. Is ready. Let it cool down at room temperature and make a fine paste out of it. Now here I have taken a pressure cooker and heat it, add oil to it. So I have been adding about 2.5 teaspoons of oil to this. And here I have made the paste of the chilies and the onion mixture, the coconut and everything. You'll see I have made very fine paste out of it. And our pressure cooker is also now, the oil has heated, 2.5 teaspoons of oil in it. And then I have 1.5 teaspoons of mustard seeds. Adjust the flame as and when required. And then add 1/2 teaspoon of asafoetida or hing. And add 1 teaspoon of turmeric. Add sliced onions. Here I'm using 1 medium-sized onion. And let the onions become a little light golden brown in color. Once they are nice light golden brown, we'll be adding the paste to this, the chili and the onion paste. And we are going to mix it well. Now you're going to cook this for about 2 to 3 minutes, and then we'll be adding 1.5 cup of sprouted val or the butter beans, lima beans, and mix it well. We'll be adding water to adjust the consistency, so about 1.5 to 2 cups of water or as required. Then we'll add salt as per taste. And we'll be adding 2 teaspoons of red chili powder to this. And 2 teaspoons of Kashmiri red chili powder for the intense red color. So 2 teaspoons of Kashmiri red chili powder. And now we're going to mix this and cook it for about 2 to 3 minutes on high flame. And once it's nice and boiled, and after 2 to 3 minutes, we're going to pressure cook it for about 2 to 3 whistles. So after about 3 whistles, the Vaalachi usal is ready. Serve it piping hot. So yeah, please do like my video, subscribe to my channel, The Joy of Cooking. Hit the bell icon for the notifications of the new recipe videos that I share. Follow me on other social media handles like Pinterest, Instagram and Facebook. I'll see you next time with some more exciting recipe videos. Until then, stay tuned and take care. Bye-bye.